Hi everybody, welcome to another episode of Exploring Photography right here on Adorama TV. I'm Mark Wallace, and in this episode, I have some time-saving tips for video content creators, specifically content creators that are creating videos that they're uploading regularly to either YouTube or Vimeo or Facebook or Twitter or an FTP account. These are people that are creating similar content over and over again. Maybe it's a vlog, maybe you have an educational series on YouTube, maybe you're a house of worship and you're uploading weekly sermon series, whatever it is, if you're creating similar content over and over again and then uploading that over and over again, keywording that, making the same titles, all that kind of stuff, well, the good news is you can automate most of that stuff in Adobe Premiere Pro. So let me just hop in here and show you exactly how this works. I'm using a real life application, a real life sample for this. This is a vlog that I'm working on this summer, riding around the Western United States. And so this is, I think, the sixth vlog here, and it's ready to go. So I just need to do a couple of things. I need to add a title to this, and I want it to look the exact same as all the other vlog titles. I want it to have the same font and size and location on the screen. And then I need to add my title and description and keywords and all of that stuff for YouTube and then upload that. And I want to automate all that stuff. So let me show you how easy this is. So the first thing I want to do is add a title. And so I'm going to use my Essential Graphics panel. Now I've already done an in-depth tutorial on how to create these and animate them and all that kind of stuff. I just want to illustrate the point that this, if you use these, you can save a ton of time. So I'm going to go in here. I've created a vlog title and an Essential Graphic that I've created as a preset. So I'm just going to drop this into the very, very first part of my project here. And then I need to change these things. So this is vlog number 6. So I can just click on that and change that. Vlog number 6. And then this is not May 30th. This is June 9th. So I'm going to click on this and say this is June 9, 2019. That looks good. And then I want to make sure this is all centered. So I can just use my little controls here to make sure that's centered. And the June 9, 2019 is centered. It is. Then I'll go ahead and put a little transition there. Now I've got my vlog all ready to go. Now let's get to the time-saving automation. Now this is really cool. So once I have my timeline selected, I can go File, Export, Media. I'm sure you've done this a billion times. And when you do that, you've got these presets you can choose from. This is going to be going to YouTube. So I know that my preset that I want to choose here is YouTube 1080p Full HD, or whichever one you're using, if it's Vimeo, YouTube, 1080 4K, whatever it is, I'm going to base this on my 1080p preset that Adobe Premiere has given me. My output name is already selected. The thing that I want to do is I want to automate the publish process. I want to automate uploading it and adding titles and all that kind of stuff. So I'm going to create a preset that I can use over and over again. And a lot of that content is already pre-populated for me. So let me show you how to do this. In the Publish tab here, you can see that there's all kinds of things you can use. You can upload to Adobe Creative Cloud, Adobe Stock, Behance, Facebook, FTP, Twitter, Vimeo, and YouTube. Now the cool thing is once you click queue and push the go button, well, all this stuff happens automatically. You don't have to sit around and wait for anything. It'll automatically encode your video and throw it up to whatever service you've selected. So we're gonna do YouTube. So the first thing I'm gonna do is click YouTube, this little check mark right here. If this is your first time doing this, you'll need to sign in to YouTube. So I've already done that, so I've got a little sign out if I need to sign out and use a different account. It's going to ask me which channel. So if you have multiple channels, you can choose one or multiple. So you can throw these to different channels all at the same time, which is really cool. Then it's going to ask what playlist. So if you've set up playlists in YouTube, you can select them here. So I want this to go to my USA 2019 vlog. You can see I've got a bunch of playlists here. That's the one I'm going to choose. So this will upload and automatically add that to my playlist. Now, the next thing I want to do is add a title. But right now, I'm creating a preset that I can use over and over again. So I'm not going to add the exact title here. I'm going to use something that I can use over and over, just a small edit. I'm going to copy and paste in a little value here. So my value is going to be vlog XX, that's the number of the vlog, and a title. So I can replace that later. The same thing is true of a description. So I'm going to add something that I can use over and over. So I've decided to make this say description goes here. So in the future, I would just replace that. And then I have all my stuff that I want to be there every single time. So my Instagram account and my my blog, so that people can find it every time. I don't have to type that in every single time. I'm gonna make sure that this goes public as soon as I click go. When it uploads, it's gonna be ready for people to view it. The other thing I wanna do here is add tags that'll be used over and over. So I already know what those are, so I'll copy and paste those in. So you can see that now I have Mark on a bike, Mark Wallace, travel, BMW, etc. And I'll just use those. I don't have to type those in anymore. This, once I've done that, it's ready to go every single time. The other thing that's really cool here is I can also add a custom thumbnail that'll show up when you go to YouTube. You can see that little thumbnail is there. So I can do this one of two ways. So the first thing I can do here is I can use my frame from my source video. So I could scrub through my video here and find something that looks pretty cool. I think there's a little puppy in here somewhere. Anyway, I could find something that looks cool and I could say, yeah, this frame right here, use that frame as the thumbnail. What I want to do is I want to make sure that my title shows up and everything I've typed in here. So I'm going to use this frame specifically. So I'm going to say use current frame. So it's using this frame at the very, very start of my video. Or what I could do is I could choose an image file. So I could create something in Photoshop or wherever, whatever image editor, and make it really fancy and have graphics and everything. I could upload that one as well. So I can choose something from the video or something I've created offline. So I'm just gonna use my frame from my source video. And then if you want, you can also have Adobe Premiere delete the local file. In other words, it'll encode your file, upload it wherever you want it to go. Once it's there, it'll delete the local file so you don't clog up your hard drive. I like to keep my local file, so I'm not gonna select that. What I'm gonna do here is, right here at the very top where it has preset, now it says custom. And then next to that, there's this little button that I can save a preset. So I'm gonna create a preset. So I'm gonna click on there. I'm gonna say vlog, Mark on a bike, 2019, and I'll hit okay. Oh, one of the things that's very important to do before you hit okay, and that is you need to make sure you save your publish settings. That will save all the information that you just typed in, those keywords, the description, the title, all that kind of stuff. It'll save that. And then also, if you dabble with some of the effects, we don't have time to go into that today, but if you do and you want to add that to a preset, make sure you save that. So I can click OK, and once I do that, I'll show you how this looks. So now my preset says vlog Mark on a bike 2019 up here, which is what we just saved. So let me cancel out of this and show you what this would look like if I use this every single time. This is the whole point. So I've set it up, I'm ready to use this over and over. So let's say I'm working on my next vlog and I'm ready to go. So all I have to do here is go in here to File, Export, Media, just like we did before. But this time, instead of choosing my YouTube thing, I'll just use my preset that says Vlog Mark on a Bike 2019. And now look what happens. All my stuff for YouTube is already there. I don't have to do that again. So then I can go in here and I can change the things that I need to change. So this is vlog number 6. The title is LA to San Francisco. And then I can go and replace this description. Instead of description goes here, I'm gonna highlight that and copy and paste. So now you can see that I've got this description that's in there. I'm gonna make this public. I'm going to make sure that I choose this custom thumbnail. So this is one thing you have to do every single time. So I'm gonna make sure this is at the very, very beginning. And then I'm gonna say use this custom, this current frame. And then I'll just queue this up. So I'll hit queue. That's gonna throw that over into Adobe Media Encoder, or you could just hit go, but I like to use Adobe Media Encoder. I'll click the green arrow, the go button, and now this is going to encode my video, upload the video, and make sure everything is all good on YouTube. Now remember, this works for YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, Vimeo, FTP sites. Those publish settings are there for you to use any way you want. Well, the upload is finished, so let's zip over to YouTube and see how we did. Well, you can see that all the stuff we entered into our Adobe Premiere export panel is here in YouTube. So the title, the description, that custom thumbnail we used, all the tags, it's public, it's on the proper playlist. Everything is there and ready to go. It's pretty simple to set up, and once you have it done, you can really save yourself a lot of time and make sure things are consistent along the way. Well, I hope that this helps you in your video production, and I want to say thank you for watching. Make sure that you subscribe to Adorama TV. It's absolutely free. That way you don't miss anything. Also, make sure you turn on the bell to get notifications. Thanks again for joining me, and I will see you again next time.